started today with our reading selection, which is Master Jumpers. So this is the page that you should have out and ready to go. Master Jumpers, page 13. Okay. We're going to go ahead and get started with the first little paragraph that you see there. It says, "One of God's amazing creatures is the kangaroo, which lives in Australia. Though there are many smaller animals that hop about, kangaroos are the only large animals that get around by hopping." Okay, stop there. So let's talk about that word hop. What is that? What's to hop? That's to saltar, right? Like that. So we see here these kangaroos. They move, they go to different places by saltando. They jump, they hop in order to get from place to place. They don't caminar like we do. They jump everywhere they go. They're the única animales grandes that is the way that they are able to go from one place to another. That's pretty cool, right? Most other animals just walk or run where they need to go. Kangaroos, they hop. So pretty cool. How many of you like kangaroos? They're neat animals, right? We're gonna learn a little more about them and how they hop. Okay, let's look at the second paragraph. Here we go. Kangaroos can come in many shapes and sizes. So many formas y tamaños. But the largest is the red kangaroo, which can grow to be 6 feet tall. The red kangaroo's leap can be as high as 10 feet and as far as 25 feet. That's some powerful jumping. Okay, let's stop there. Look at that word leap, L-E-A-P. Leap, that's another word for saltando. So, el salto de the red kangaroo. It can be as high, so as alto, as 10 feet. That's pretty tall. That's like if you stacked two of me on top of each other, you would get 10 feet. You'd actually have a little more, but close enough. Then it can be as far, so that means as long, let's say they start here and they jump, it can go as far as 25 feet. That's like the length of our aula here. So that's a really high, far jump, right? Whew, could you imagine being able to jump 25 feet away from you? Wow, pretty cool. Well, how do they do that? Let's see. The secret to the kangaroo's mighty leaps, so that just means it's saltos que están poderoso, are in its feet. God made the kangaroo with very large, powerful back feet. The feet of the red kangaroo can be 1.5 feet long. God also gave the kangaroo a powerful tail that helps him to balance when he's jumping. Okay, so that tail helping him to balance, that word balance, that's to equilibrar, to tener balancia. That's what he uses his big, strong tail for, to keep from falling over when he's jumping. So you can see in this picture down at the bottom, look at how big their back feet are, right? They have big back feet. If you look at this picture, you can see it as well. Those big back feet. It says that the red kangaroo's feet can be 1.5 feet long. This is 1 foot, and this is about another half. So that would be the length from this end to here would be about the length of a red kangaroo's feet. Whoosh, that's big, right? That's how big their feet are. Good thing they don't need shoes. Okay, let's finish up our page. Our God is a master creator and thinks of every detail, even the details that make master jumpers. So Cuando Dios estaba creando todo en su creación, Él estaba pensando en cada detalle. Even los detalles que están pequeñitos, Él estaba pensando en eso. Y Él hace una creación de grandes saltandos. Okay, turn your paper over. Let's follow the directions. Number one says, circle the best answer. The author of this story wants to, and then you have two choices, inform us about kangaroos or entertain us with a fun story. Okay, what does this mean? The author of the story wants to. So el escritor de esa historia quiere que. ¿Cuál es su propuesto en escribir esa historia? ¿Él quiere informarnos sobre los kangaroos? ¿O él quiere que esa historia es divertida para nosotros? Which one is it? Circle the answer. It's the first one. Él quiere informarnos. He wants to inform us about kangaroos. He gives us a lot of information to help us learn more about them. Okay, number two, circle the sentence that is a fact about kangaroos. So the thing that you know is true. It's not an opinion, it's something that is always true no matter what. Okay, the first sentence says, kangaroos are the only large animals that get around by hopping. Or, kangaroos are the best jumpers in the whole world. Circle the one that is a fact, the one that is true to you. If you were to say it, it's not your opinion. No one could disagree. No one could say that that is wrong. It's the first one. Kangaroos are the only large animals that get around by hopping. The second one, kangaroos are the best jumpers in the whole world. Well, maybe somebody else might say, no, I don't think so. I think that bunny rabbits actually do a better job, or something like that. Excuse me. The next part is a crossword. So, excuse me. Ooh, something stuck in my throat. Okay. So for this, what you need to do is follow the clues. So you have different clues, different pistas that tell you which words you need. Where it says across right there, that means that the word that answers the clue has to go across this way. Horizontal. But the words that go with the down clues, they go like this, por abajo, okay? So let's look at the first across clue. It says the body part that allows a kangaroo to leap. What is the body part that allows a kangaroo to leap? You might have to look back in your story. It's his feet, right? Those great big feet that he has. So that goes with across two. So you're going to look in your puzzle for the number two. Uh-huh, there's the number two. So you will write feet in the blank for number two. Put the first letter in the first box, the second letter in the second box, the next letter in the third box, and the last letter in the last box. Okay, let's do number one going down together. You need to do four across by yourself, but let's look at number one going down together. It says, our God is a master what? Well, that clue is pointing to the first sentence of the last paragraph. Our God is a master what? Okay, that clue goes with number one going down. So we need to search our puzzle for the one that has the number one. Oh, found it right there. So you will write creator, which is the answer, in that puzzle. Notice how it fits. C-R-E-A-T-O-R. Okay, and now you need to finish the rest of the puzzle by yourself. Read the pieces, read the clues, look in your story to find the answers. Have a wonderful day, guys. I love you very much.